Yeah, I wanted to end this lecture with some additional topics because, yeah, over the years I bookmarked so many interesting articles. I didn't even have a chance to read them all. There are hundreds of interesting articles related to optimization. But yeah, if you're interested, I have a small selection of things here that you may find interesting. So let's start with Adam. So going back to the original paper, the Adam paper from 2014. So you can see there are several other methods that they looked at, and this is from 2014. Nowadays there are maybe at least five times more methods out there that people suggest to use compared to regular SGD. So one thing, for example, that we also didn't talk about is SGD Nesterov, which is a modified version of SGD with momentum. It's like this Nesterov momentum. In theory, it may work better than the regular momentum. I also wanted to cover it in this lecture. Actually, I made the slides for that, but then I removed them because I noticed otherwise the lecture would be just too long. And most people in practice use the regular momentum again anyways. So SGD with a regular momentum is also among the best algorithms, even though it's the simplest one, and I will explain to you in a few slides why. So Adam, like I said, is cool because it doesn't require as much tuning, but also SGD is also, in terms of generalization performance, really good. So to make this point, so this plot, this is looking at the training cost or training loss, and you can see in this paper they find that Adam really performs best compared to other methods when it comes to the training cost or loss. However, a low training cost doesn't imply that the final model generalizes well to new data. Maybe it's just overfitting. So what I mean is, of course we want to achieve a low training cost, but that alone is not enough. We can end up with a low training cost, but then if we have a high degree of overfitting, then the resulting model still isn't so good, for example, compared to a model that has a higher training loss but a lower overfitting and may have a better generalization performance. So to explain you more in detail what I mean, here's a visualization from a paper from I actually don't know which year. I think it was 2017. I should have included it here, but here they also looked at different optimization algorithms. They looked at the training error here and the test error. So what is interesting is that they find they have Adam, the optimized one, like hyperparameter tuning, and the default one. Most people, I said, use the default one, but in this case the default one performs really bad. So the tuned one performs better here. But yeah, in contrast to the previous slide, that I can't explain. In contrast to the previous slide, they find that on the training set, SGD performs better than Adam. So HB is a heavy ball method, it's another method. But this is like a little bit different from what I've shown you in the previous slide. Nonetheless, the takeaway here is more like what's happening on the test set. So on the test set, that is usually what we care about. Here they also find that regular SGD performs better than Adam. And this is not unique to this single paper. This is something that has been observed by other people as well, that SGD, if it's tuned well, it has usually the best generalization performance. One possible explanation for that is that SGD is just noisier, and because of this noise, it's maybe easier to avoid certain sharp minima, or it's easier to let's say, first of all, wiggle out of some local minima, but then also maybe to don't find such a good loss. So if you find a loss that is very low, you may end up overfitting. In that case, maybe having a higher training loss is maybe sometimes not as bad. Okay, so that is one point why people still sometimes prefer SGD compared to more fancy algorithms like here, listed here. Yeah, there was also a fun paper where they essentially suggest switching from Adam to SGD over the course of training. So they say, despite superior training outcomes, adaptive optimization methods such as Adam, Adagrad, or RMSProp have been found to generalize poorly compared to SGD. So it's essentially what I said in the previous slide, that regular SGD can usually yield better generalization performance. And they say these methods tend to perform well in the initial portion of the training, but are outperformed by SGD in the later stages of training. We investigate a hybrid strategy that begins with training an adaptive method, so using Adam, and then switching to SGD when appropriate. So here they have essentially compared SGD and Adam. So using SGD first and then, using Adam first and then switching to SGD. So yeah, here is also again a plot showing the test error, showing that with SGD you can end up with a lower test error, so a better generalization performance compared to the orange here to Adam. Here's a blog article also listing all the strengths and weaknesses of these different algorithms, like taking an objective view. So here they didn't develop a particular method, because usually when you read a paper where people propose a new method, the new method is of course better than the previous methods, but here this is someone just summarizing these different methods and coming up with some takeaways. So yeah, in terms of the state memory, how many memory that requires in addition on your GPU, because you have additional parameters, but then also the hyperparameters that you need to tune. So of course SGD is the simplest one. Momentum, you add an additional number of parameters here, and also tunable parameters. I don't know where the second one comes from. One is the learning rate and the other one is of course the momentum term, but the beta. But yeah, I was just wondering, okay. Anyways, so here they also say that it's the best for generalization, but requires extensive training, so requires more tuning for the learning rate, but also more epochs. And then this one accelerates and overcomes weaknesses, so on and forth. And here with Adam, they also say it generalizes worse than SGD. So yeah, this is an interesting other algorithm, Adam W. So it improves Adam in terms of generalization, but requires more state memory. It's the same as this one, so it's in that way not much worse than regular Adam. But Adam W is also something I've recently seen people using. It's a little bit better than the regular Adam. But yeah, if you're interested, you can read this article for more details, for more detailed comparison of different methods. So here was also an interesting take on Adam again. So people often use Adam and say Adam performs just well across many different architectures. And here this person argues this may be because architectures evolved to make Adam the best optimizer. So here the person says that it is known that Adam will not always give you the best performance. Yet most of the time people know that they can use it without its default performance. So you don't need to change the default parameters, and usually you can get good performance on your problem just out of the box. So that is also what I observed in practice. But here the argument is maybe it's not because Adam works so well, it's because Adam worked so well in the past, and now with these new architectures people just keep using Adam, and the new architectures that evolved expect that people use Adam. So Adam is essentially a good fit for these architectures, because these architectures were evolved with Adam in mind. So there's like this evolution kind of bias here. So here the person also says usually people try new architectures keeping the optimization algorithm fixed, and most of the time the algorithm of choice is Adam. This happens because, as explained above, Adam is the default optimizer. It's like a chicken egg problem in a way. So and recently that was saw that a couple of weeks ago actually in a talk, this figure. So there was also some additional independent evaluation of these different optimization algorithms. And here essentially the argument is really it does not matter what type of optimization algorithm you use. So on the left hand side, this is a ResNet 18, a residual network, which we will talk about this and next week. So it's a type of convolutional network. And here this is a multilayer perceptron. And they train this on Cypher 10, so both methods. And here this is the accuracy on the test set. And the blue one is the test training set, and the red one is the test set. Let me write this down. Train and test. And you can see the training set accuracy for both convolutional networks and fully connected networks, multilayer perceptrons here, are essentially the same, the training set accuracies. However, the test set accuracy here that's a huge difference. So architecture can make a huge difference in terms of the generalization performance, even though, let's say, the training accuracy remains the same. So architecture choice is very important. However, in contrast to the architecture choice, so here they trained a VGG13, which is a different convolutional network. So for this training here, they used different optimization algorithms, for example, SGD, SGD with momentum, SGD with Nesterov momentum, or ADAM here. And you can see that while the training performance is slightly different, maybe the test set performance is almost identical. You can see that there's almost virtually no difference in the test set performance, maybe 1 or 2 percentage points. And yeah, here really what we can see is that honestly, the type of optimization algorithm that we use doesn't matter that much as we might think. It's really, if you want to, let's say, get better performance, it's probably better to look at different architectures rather than different optimization algorithms. That being said, there was recently also a new optimizer that was pretty popular, or became very popular very quick. Let's say I saw that in several discussion forums. So there's this Ada Belief optimizer, which is essentially a modification of ADAM. So here on the left-hand side is the regular ADAM optimizer, and on the right-hand side is this Ada Belief optimizer, and in blue, so I can also use blue here, in the blue font you can see the little changes to it. I don't want to discuss this in too much detail because I want to wrap up this lecture. It was long enough, but yeah, this is another interesting new optimizer, and of course you can see it performs better than the other ones. In blue here, that's the Ada Belief optimizer, and it outperforms other optimizers using VGG11 and ResNet34, which are both convolutional networks that we will talk about, and we will also start using Cypher 10 then.